and heals our own product on our life. We already have a trademark register, but unfortunately, we still not receive permit to be sell in the broad market. But we already have a trademark Makufit Dry and Makufit Oil. And we also test that the protein in the black soldier fly larvae contain at least 19 amino acids. As you can see, this our test with our colleagues, yeah, from PT Biosato Indo, we test the protein and contain at least 19 amino acids. So what about the oil? The oil also very, very prospective, because as I mentioned earlier, that the oil is similar to the coconut oil. And then they have a lauric acid that is a powerful antibacterial. We also compare the PSL oil with the corn oil and coconut oil. And the results say that the palmitic acid of the PSL oil is higher than corn oil or even coconut oil. And some people ask me on how to produce oil from the black soldier fly larvae. Currently, we propose our simple pattern to the HKI. What the HKI means? Direktorat Kemenhukam, yeah. For the government, something like that. Yeah, property right. To on how to simple way to get oil from the black soldier fly larvae. It is a simple. We harvest the black soldier fly larvae, we washing, and then we cleaning, and then we put in the hot water for 3 minutes, and then we microwave. After that, we put in the oil extractor, and we cut this oil. But we still need bleaching and deodorization. The other product, as I mentioned earlier, that fresh, because after black soldier fly larvae eat the substrate, they will pop, they will produce organic fertilizer, namely fresh. And this is the result with my colleagues in United States when I was in visiting research in USA. They test the fresh from the SFL, that they contain a huge amount of macronutrient as well as useful bacteria. And this also a hand soap, a liquid hand soap that we make by ourselves based on the oil from black soldier fly larvae. Again, this hand soap is already has a trademark, but still need permit to be sell in the market. Hopefully, maybe next year, you can see in the supermarket our product, black soldier hand soap from black soldier fly larvae. Just use it. Don't imagine the larvae. And this one, our ointment from the black soldier fly larvae from forward healing incision, but still need more research to be conducted. And what the other future prospect of the black soldier fly larvae? As I mentioned earlier, that the oil from black soldier fly larvae, the composition is similar to the coconut oil, so we can use it for fry. And even the oil from black soldier fly larvae, it also contains important fatty acid like omega-3, omega-6, and omega-9. It is depend what they eat. If you give the substrate like fish waste and palm kernel meal, they will contain high omega-3 and omega-6, as well as omega-9. So this product is come from our partner in West Java, PT Biomed. They can already product, make a product, market meal, market oil, for wound medicine, natural soap, and also aromatherapy. And this one is very interesting. In Europe, there is a 0.68 that for skin, insect skin. This is for the beauty. This oil also derived from the larvae, from the insect. As well, fragrant. They have a letter in the mobile. It's very interesting. Now, final, about the sustainability. Okay, we think that the larvae is very useful because they help us to convert the waste into the useful product. But wait, what about the sustainability? We try to conduct a research using the life cycle assessment. This LCA, or life cycle assessment, is a standard method to assess the impact of rearing of black soldier fly larvae to the environment. So we try to conduct research and analyze what energy consumed, what fuel, how many fuel that we consume when we rear and produce, for example, 100 kilos of black soldier fly larvae. How many water that we use? How many hours light that we use? And how much nitrogen, how many ammonia that out by the larvae? So we make this system Bundari, the limitation of our study. We try to make the input and output and the process, and we analyze the how much the diesel, how much the petrol, how much the electricity that we need to rearing the black soldier fly larvae, how much the water, how much the natural gas. So the result state that we found the hotspot that may be potential to increase the global warming potential. So this one is the hotspot. For the production of pre-pupae. Because when we produce pre-pupae, they emit nitrogen, they emit ammonia mainly. And then, this step of production of pre-pupae also has a higher potential in acidification, also terrestrial eutrophication, also fossil fuel depletion. So, in conclusion for sustainability, we have to be aware that in production of pre-pupae, maybe it will increase global warming potential, acidification, terrestrial eutrophication, and ecotoxicity. Meanwhile, the production of biomass, it will deplete the fossil fuel. Because when we give the substrate for the black soldier fly larvae, sometimes we destroy it first using the machine. So it will need the fossil fuel. So this one is very interesting. Imagine that this process also comparable when we think which one is more sustainable, the glass from the plastic or the glass from the paper. Maybe some of you think that the glass from the plastic is dangerous. But if we try using the LCA, it is concluded that using the glass from the plastic is more sustainable than the glass from the paper. I think this is all from my presentation. I hope you interest and thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much.